my garden, but before I will show you everything, I will say something about myself so you can know me better. So I did many different things in my life. I had some businesses, I worked in some places like restaurants, really many things. In 1 year I had a period of time when I was traveling a lot. I was traveling by hitchhike through all Europe actually. And then I stayed in Croatia for a few months. And then, first time in my life, in this place, I heard about permaculture. It's a kind of agriculture, it's about making a garden in different way. So we had there some kind of community with travelers, with people who wanted to join. After this, when I go back to Poland, again I had 1 year companion, and then I moved to the Czech Republic for Erasmus Plus program. And in this place, I could have some kind of mini project, so I could choose what I want to do. European Union give some like some small cash for finance the project, and I could make my own garden there. So I choose piece of ground, I prepare everything from the ground, from zero, and I make beautiful garden with beautiful, very tasty vegetables. So when I go back here to Poland, I wanted to do it again. I wanted to try it in my home, in my place, in my city, to make the same garden in the same technique. So that's what I'm trying to do here. It's just the beginning actually of the year, of the season, so you will not see a lot of things. I'm sure in next 2-3 months it will be much better, everything will be bigger, and we will see nice fruits. Now it's not that much to see, but I want to show you something about technique, how to make good garden in with a little bit different technique. Permaculture is, to be honest, definition of this is quite difficult. It's a lot of things which are common, like together, make a permaculture. For me, it's like making your garden similar to the natural ecosystems. And you do it with many different techniques. For example, to put something on the top of your ground. Because one of the rules of permaculture is that you never leave the ground bald without anything, because if you go to the forest or jungle or anyway, yeah, then you will see that always there is something on the ground. For example, in forest there is always some leaves, there is always some needles, for example, from some kind of cheese, a lot of things. And because of this, nature protect the ground. So one of these techniques is putting something on top. I put here the straw, and it protect ground from the fast evaporating of water, so it keep it's keep water inside the ground for a longer time. It make nice climate for worms, for example. When I come here and the ground was very bad, I put some mulching fertilizers, and then I put this straw. After 1 week, maybe two, there was a lot of worms inside. Before it wasn't like this, but after this, it was many good worms who make this ground much better for the plants. So it's also because of the straw. So this is one of them. There's a lot of different techniques to make it more similar to natural ecosystem, and it's also kind of self-sufficient. When you look for the nature, you have many different species of plants in one place. For example, in jungle you can have even like 20 different species of plants in 1 square meter, and everything somehow is connected with each other, so every plant have some rules. For example, when you make your garden, what I do here is, for example, I put tomatoes, and next to the tomatoes there is some plants who make that these tomatoes taste better. For example, I also put some plants which make that snail don't want to eat your plants. They don't want to go inside your garden because they don't like smell of this plants. I did the same in Czech Republic, and it works really nice. And this is also nature duo. It's like this self-sufficient way. Also, permaculture is like being good with nature. Is like protecting the nature. When you don't destroy ground or animals, you don't use any chemicals in your garden, because it can destroy also the ground, all insects which lives there, or different animals who are also good for garden sometimes. So it's very big topic, I would say. It's like topic for 2 hours just talking about it. It's many different rules. There's like 3 basic rules, then it's 12 next rules, which is like more about this one thing. Also, what is nice with permaculture garden is that you don't work so much on your garden, because when you do it in a proper way, for example, even giving the straw, then you don't need to put water that much to ground. If you leave the ground open, then when it's a very big sun, then one day maybe, and all the ground is dry again, and you have to put water every day, or at least 1 per 2 days. If you have something on top which protect your ground from evaporating, you go and you put water 1 per 4 days, for example. And if you put, for example, some pieces of wood deeper in the ground, which is name of this technique is hygro technique, then for example water go inside, stay in wood works like sponge in this case, and if it's when it's too much water, then wood stay there. If it's dry, then water go out from this wood, and then you can have you don't need to put water to your garden for a long time. There is one video about a man who didn't put water from 1 year for his own garden, like 1 year no watering plants, and this exists, it's still working. It's enough that water, that there is rain like a few days in month, for example, and it is okay. And about sustainable farm, it's also about sustainable way of living, I would say, because it's not just farm. In the farm, it's like when, for example, all the waste you have, like first of all, you don't waste the things, but for example, if you have some rest from thing which you eat, you can put it again to the garden, for example, and then you give again some ingredients to the ground. For example, some people, it's also part of permaculture, they when they have homes which is also this same self-sufficient, they put some toilet box outside of home, and the like poop from there they put again to the garden, for example. So they also put some ingredients, but it's also important in this case to compost this before, to don't put fresh poop, I will say, to the garden. And also to eat healthy, because if you eat bad things, you will put these things again to the garden. If you eat for example vegetables from your own garden, you don't eat some sweet things or something which have a lot of chemicals inside, then it's like more healthy, and you can put it again. But I'm not sure if people also use it for example vegetables, or mostly for plants which just look nice, for example, or for cheese. Energy can be also from the nature. You can have for example solar panels, you can have what is the name? These things which product wind energy from wind. You remember?
Fuck, I know you only.
So the thing which product
from wind.
That's all I can say in English. So even energy you can product by yourself. So you product your food. Also, sometimes if you want to have animals, you can have, for example, chickens, and they can also give you eggs. If you have too much chickens, you can always eat some. If you are not vegetarian, and in this case also we are sure that the chickens had like good life and everything because they have place to run, and it's not like in this big big farms when they product like thousands of chickens and they are in very bad conditions. This is not good even to eat, to don't support this companies. Also, for example, you can use animals to help in your garden, because for example it's also some kind of technique when you have a piece of ground and you don't want to dig it, but a little bit like move the ground, so you put put some chickens there. It's like and then they you know, use these legs to look for some insects in ground, and in this case like they make this ground better for growing for plants. So basically they do your work. And the same thing can make for example pig, but pigs with their noses they even go deeper and like dig the ground deeper than the chicken. So also some people use it, so you don't need to have tools in this way. And if you protect your ground, you take care about the ground, about soil, then it's good for many years also. So it's also kind of self-sufficient because you don't need to put again many fertilizers, and you don't need to even dig the ground. If you do it once, good. You protect the top, there is a lot of insects which help you make better ground. You put your waste or compost on the ground. If you have, for example, this wood deep inside, if you use different kind of plants which have them own they own job to do. For example, one plant can have big roots, so they take ingredients to the top of the ground for those plants who don't have so deep roots, for example. So it's kind of cooperating. If you have plants who bring the bees, also you will have more bees in the garden, and it will be also better. So if you have really good design garden and you protect this ground, then you have ground for many years. It's just work by themselves. So it is self-sufficient. Okay, so let's see the soil. Here, let's see how it looks like. So, because I use this straw, you can see that the ground is very soft. It's still wet, and it didn't rain for a few days, and it's still dry there. You can see, like, straw is still wet. Next, there is part of ground which is not mine, where is nothing on the top. And it's dry in some places. So this is the difference with permaculture and traditional agriculture. You see, like very, it's wet. Here you can see some insects walking. So it's a good climate for many of them. There is here you can see the worm. See? You see a lot of worms here, and they are very, very good for the ground. Because they have conditions to live here. The ground is good, they are protected by straw. See a lot of them. They make the ground very good. And to make ground better, I use some fertilizers. Here you can see it's horse manure, which is also decomposted with a good quality. And before I dig ground, a little bit, but it's also to protect your ground. It's good to dig only first time. Then you don't dig your ground completely. You just move it a little bit, because the ground have some layers also. If you move the ground or the layers, bacteria are like mixed, and it's not good for ground. And to make nice layers, for example, you can put one layer of some wood, for example, or some wooden chops, so they take some water when it's wet, when it's raining, and then they put out the water when it's dry season, when it's a lot of sun, for example, and they also can help the ground. This can be one layer, for example. Second layer, you can have, let's say, this ground. Then you can have layer of horse manure, for example. Then you can have also this straw for a layer. So it's good to leave it like this. Also, to make your soil better, you can use the plants who have very big and deep roots, because they put some air inside your ground, for example. They put some ingredients from deeper part to the upper part, and they make ground more soft, so it's not that like it's not like one piece, but it's more like it's just better. Okay, also when your ground is good and soft, it's much easier to take out some weeds. You see, I just take them out, and they go with roots. So it's much easier. If you have hard ground, dry, not that soft, then it's difficult. You have to use a lot of your power to put them out, and after bigger part of garden, you can be very tired. With this, you just take them to the fingers and just move it out. It's really easy. I'm sure that if you compare the taste of the vegetables from your own garden and you take the vegetables from supermarkets, you will see a big difference. You will see that your own vegetables from your garden will be much more tasty. And the question is, what is the difference between those vegetables? Both of them are, for example, tomatoes, but they taste different. Okay, so answer is, because if you use only natural things in your garden, for example, these all things which I told before, like this, for example, horse manure and everything, if you use the compost, then your soil is full of minerals. It's full of good ingredients, which also goes to your vegetables. And when vegetables have more this good ingredients, vitamins, everything, they are also more tasty. For example, if you have tomatoes from supermarket, which is grown in mass way, so they don't care so much about the quality, but they want to make them fast, so they use the chemicals, they destroy this ground, everything, and they have maybe faster harvesting, maybe they have more these tomatoes, but they don't have this taste, because they are kind of fake. They don't even have the vitamins. There was some scientist they checked the level of vitamins in some vegetables, and then they realized that after many years, for example, now the level of vitamins of vegetables and fruits is much smaller than, let's say, 20-30 years before, because before more people use some natural ways, and now this big farms goes more like they want more money, so they use more chemicals and all these things to have it the harvesting faster. So the way of this gardening is different. And then this is why the taste is also different. It's just differences with ingredients inside the vegetable. So if something is very tasty, it's more probably that it will be healthy. It's also, for example, sometimes you can see that these more healthy things are maybe don't look that nice, because for example some American snail eat something, for example, or sometimes you can see that there is something on the skin. And when you go to the supermarkets, most of those vegetables are so beautiful, you know, there is not even scratch or not even bit of insects. So why insects don't eat these vegetables? Because they are so chemical inside, the insects just don't want to eat it, but we eat it. So that's why it's so perfect. So sometimes it's even good to choose maybe less beautiful the vegetable, and it's more chance that it will be healthy. But of course the best way is just to have your own garden, own place, when you can be 100% sure that it's completely healthy without any just chemicals and etc.